Hey guys, I'm Pierre from Spyder TV and Can Am SpyderAccessories.com. Welcome to my shop. In this video, we're going to be talking about one of these. It's the short antenna for your RT Can Am Spyder. You may be wondering why change the antenna on the Can Am Spyder on the RT if you already got one that's working. Well, the first reason might be just for aesthetic purposes. You like the short one better than the tall original one. The second one might be that it just broke off. Unfortunately, it broke off on my dad's Can Am Spyder a couple of weeks back, and that's how this project came about. And the other one might be because you're using a cover because you're on the road often, or you just park your Spyder outside and you need to put a cover, and the tall antenna, you know, you need to bend it very often to be able to get your cover on the Spyder. The antenna we're going to use is from a company called Scosche, and the easiest place to find one was at Walmart of all places. It's about 10 bucks, and it's part number RMA900. If you go on walmart.com, the website, probably the easiest way, type in the part number and you'll find the Walmart that has them in stock closest to where you live. The package comes with a lot of stuff. Not all of it we're going to be using, so this for sure we won't need. For the rest, well, we'll go ahead and put this together and you'll see exactly what you're going to need. First step, well, if your antenna is still intact and it hasn't broken off, it's going to look something like this. And if it's broken off, then you've got different pieces maybe that are left, or the whole thing might have come off. So if we want to go ahead and remove this rubber part here, the easiest way is simply put two fingers underneath and two fingers on each side. You can kind of squeeze it and wiggle it a little bit and it's just going to come right off. For this part, we're going to need to take out the antenna, so to unscrew it. This is where we're going to be using the long nose pliers, vice grip if you have them. Now the problem is that I'm having is that this is a 2010 RT. And from what I can remember, there's a lot of Loctite in there, and the yellow kind. So when I'm trying to get my pliers in with the angle, it's actually giving me a bit of trouble. To give you an example here with the long nose wires, it's hard for me to get a good grip and get, you know, some good torque to unscrew it. And I'm having a bit of problem. And from what I'm seeing is that if I keep going this way, I'm actually going to eat away with the pliers as they're turning, with the plastic that's holding down that rubber cap that we just removed. So this is a bad thing, but a good thing. We're actually gonna have to remove the side panel here, and I'll go ahead and show you that. So if this happens to you, at least you know there's a solution. Don't try to get it out if it's nice and tight and your pliers are going away at the plastic. If you break that off, you're not gonna be able to put back that rubber cap. And we're going to start off by taking out this panel right here. And this is the panel that goes all the way to the back. So you have two screws to take out here. That's a Torque 30. So the two screws that are here. And let me take my camera off my tripod here and show you the other ones that we're going to be taking off as well. All right, so you're going to have to take off the four screws that are here as well. One, two, three, and four. And we're gonna open up the other side of the bike, and we're gonna do the same thing as well. On this side, you're also gonna have to remove the two screws that are here. Let's go ahead and get that done, and then we'll go to the next step. For these two bolts right here, it's going to be a Torque 20. on the inside, we're going to need to take out three bolts. There's one right at the top here, one here, and one down here. And that's going to be a torque 30. We can now take off the side panel. By pulling on the wires a little bit, you'll be able to see that this is where the antenna plugs into the audio on the bike. To be able to work properly and not damage anything, well, I'm gonna make the choice. This is up to you, but I'll make the choice to take out the antenna here, unplug this, and I'm gonna take out this bolt here and be able to walk away with this piece here and work on my bench. You're gonna need a 10 millimeter socket to be able to take out this bolt right here. You're gonna need to unplug the audio system wires right here. There's a couple more of T20, torque 20 screws to remove. There's one right here. And on the back, you're gonna have 1, 2, 3, and 4. It's gonna take you a 7 millimeter to be able to take out this one right here. The reason that I needed to take out the speaker part to get to the antenna was because of this. I have a 2010, and see how that is? It's just a round piece. It's not like a key. It doesn't have like edges, straight edges, so I could get a key in there and be able to have a little bit of a hold to be able to turn it. It's just a flat, a round piece. And that was my main problem. See all the teeth mark I have already on there from the vice grip. So that's the part that was giving me problems. I'm gonna go ahead and reassemble the whole thing, including this piece here. Take my time, do a nice job, put the bike back together, and then we're gonna finish up that antenna that we started. When putting back the antenna right here, I suggest you go ahead and put some electrical tape. We have quite a few of these. You have 5 of them. The one that we're going to be using is the one that has the same threads on each side. And the way you can check that is by taking your antenna and this bit right here. Go ahead and just turn that in. Yeah, fits well. And the other side as well. All good. So this is the one we're going to be using. As you can see here, I now have my drill, 3/8 drill bit. And the reason we need that is for this rubber part here that we take out, that's the original part that we're going to be using again. And since the diameter of this antenna is a lot bigger than the one on the original, we're going to need to make this hole bigger. I found that using the drill makes a nice job. The reason I didn't want to use a utility knife is that I was scared that if I made an incision here and for some reason I did something wrong, or I made it go too far, I didn't make a nice round, then unfortunately then I might have that rubber split wide open. So with the drill bit, I was able to, nice and slowly, be careful when you do this. And you're able to work at it, make the round a little bit bigger, so your antenna will now have a perfect fit. For this step, we're going to go ahead and put some Loctite. Put some Loctite on the, you'll see that on one side you have more threads on this side than that side. That's the part we're going to go and put in the spider. You're going to need a 1/4-inch key for this part here on the antenna. It's got two flat surfaces on each side. We'll need that when we're ready to make everything nice and tight on the spider. Now we can just go ahead and screw this into the Can Am Spyder. For the final part, we're going to put the rubber here. I recommend that you have a small screwdriver flathead. You may need it to be able to tuck in these little parts here so it fits nice and tight. So that was the installation of the short antenna on your Can Am Spyder, the RT series. It was supposed to be a short video. It was somewhat longer as I had a couple of problems with the antenna and taking it out and all that. So we solved the problem. The information is there if you need it. If it's something that happens to you, well, at least now you know how to take out that side panel. So I'm also from CanAmSpyderAccessories.com. So if you're looking for whether it's front grills, an RT itch, or all kinds of cool stuff for your Can Am Spyders, go check us out on CanAmSpyderAccessories.com, CanAmSpyderAccessories.com. And my name is Pierre, and you've been watching Spyder TV.